Everyone, and welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to do this session one of what is virtualization on my course VMware vSphere 6.7. So let's get started. Before we get started, hang on, let me remind you to subscribe to my channel and don't forget to like and hit the notification button, because this is a very important topic and I don't think I can cover it in one video session of 10 minutes, so I might need to expand it a little bit, and you don't want to miss out from my videos, so make sure you subscribe. Okay, let's get into our agenda for today. Okay, let's not forget who is this training for. Just want a recap on this. Really, anyone who wants to learn virtualization, this training is for them, because I'm going from basics and I will try to be very slow in explaining the concepts. There will be new terminology, but don't worry, you will learn it, and the more you are looking into these videos, the more you are using this terminology, you'll get used to it. As I said, no IT background or experience required, so there's no prerequisite. So let's get straight into it, right? So today's agenda is, what is virtualization? Yes, that's the buzzword which we have been talking about. So virtualization, let's get into it, and we'll also go through what are the type of virtualizations. Yeah, type 1 and type 2, cloud and different types of cloud, private, public and hybrid. So that's what I want to cover in the introduction session for this. Okay, so for what is virtualization, what I have done is I have already got some blog posts on my website. So if you go to horeshi.wordpress.com, you'll find consolidation IT infrastructure by virtualization. So you can go through this post. It will take you through a bit more detail than what I'm going to do today. If you're interested in the theory side of it. Okay, so I'll put these links in my video at the end of the video, in the description, sorry. I'll put these links in there. But okay, so I want to start off with, what is virtualization? Virtualization basically means you are using the commodity hardware, the hardware available for you, which is having CPU, memory, network and disk. Yeah. And then on top of it, as you can see, on top of this hardware, instead of running an OS directly, you will be running a hypervisor. In VMware, the hypervisor is ESXi to be precise, which has been changed to ESX. So VMware had ESX before. From version 4.1, I think they have, and anything above 5 is ESX. ESXi, sorry. So that's the terminology anyway. So let's try and draw this for you guys. So as you know, virtualization is out in the industry since more than 10 years. So I want to talk a little bit about history of how traditional data center looks like, so that you get an idea, and today's data center, and obviously we'll go through these topics. So what I want to focus on, let me draw this really. Let's cover types of virtualization. So there are types of hypervisor first. So you got the idea. So on the physical, So in the traditional world, we have a server, we have CPUs here, and we have memory banks, which they call. So they are relating to the CPUs, and we have a network card. Draw two network cards. So obviously you're connecting to your infrastructure from the switches, and also you have disk. Okay, so in the olden days, basically, well, not in the olden days, traditionally what we have, even we still have physical server, bare metal servers, Windows and Linux today as well. So we have this server and we install an OS, operating system, It could be Windows, it could be Linux, you're not talking about what OS, but what has happened and what was monitored over the period of time, as the technology is growing, the server hardware is becoming powerful and less expensive. So you can easily get a 32 GB server quite easily. But obviously, having a 32 GB server running with, say, for example, 2012, and you'll find 2008 or 2012, you'll find over the period of the lifespan. So in when I say lifespan, the when you commission a server, there's a 5 years industry standard which they say. Then the server runs, and then after 5 years it becomes a write-off, so you buy a new server to replace that server. So over the course of 5 years, the application only or the server only gets utilized up to 30% or maximum 40%, unless you are running a heavy intensive application. So we'll talk about heavy intensive application. There are some products or some application which are not fit for virtualization. We'll discuss that later on. But let's assume the bulk of the workload which we'll run is basically standard application web servers and stuff, which is utilized only 30%. So that's your server which you have invested maybe £5,000 is only getting used 30%, 30 to 40%, which isn't a good thing really, because obviously you want your resources to be maximized to be used fully. So this is why you have the same server, you have obviously CPU, memory banks, networks, yeah, which I drew here. Instead of obviously running it here locally, our single OS, we will have a thin layer of hypervisor, which is, as we discussed, ESX, which is the VMware hypervisor. We also call it vSphere. Okay, sorry about the scribbling. I'm just getting used to my new touchpad and the pen here. So so as I was saying, so the hypervisor, and then on top of that we install a virtual machine, which is basically again 2012 or 2008, and you can give it, you know, maybe it only needs 8 gig memory and two virtual CPU, 2 vCPU and 8 gig memory. So that's how we will do. But so this was just the concept. So obviously the virtual machine again will have some terminology around it. So it has a virtual CPU, as I discussed, and basically it has virtual RAM, not virtual memory. It's another concept which will be within OS. So virtual RAM, and then obviously it has its network, it has a disk, which is where the OS is installed. In VMware, the disk where the OS is installed, or the disk is virtual disk, is called VMDK. VMDK. Okay, so this is some understanding of what a virtual infrastructure will look like. So instead of having like one OS running on one hardware, you'll be having, so 8 gig one VM running here, another 12 gig VM running here, or we could have another one, you know, 4 gig running. Yeah, so we could have multiple VMs. So we have easily accommodated 3 virtual machines on one single box. So that's also server consolidation on its own, right? So let's quickly give you an idea. So let's just talk through the types of hypervisor which I wanted to discuss. So there are two types of hypervisors. Type 1 is also called as bare metal hypervisor. And then you have type 2. which is also known as hosted hypervisor. So let's just get into what exactly that means. So you have a server. Obviously, in the server you have your resources here, which is your CPU. Yeah. Your memory banks. Let's say you have your local disk, hard disk drives. You have your network card. So this could be a single switch or different switches, which in turn connects to your WAN network. Okay, so this is in general a server which you have running in your environment. So instead of just having physical server, you can create an entire virtual environment of, you know, virtual servers. To do that, we use Type1 hypervisor, which is the best type of hypervisor. So the hypervisor is a small piece of software which runs on top of the bare metal. In VMware, it is called ESXi, or you can also say it's also known as vSphere. vSphere is the hypervisor, and on top of this hypervisor, you can run multiple virtual machines. As you can see, the hardware is quite exposed very closely to the virtual machines. It just has a thin layer of hypervisor. Let's talk a little bit about the hypervisor. So the hypervisor is a very small piece of software. It's like 300 MB, and it basically is installed directly on the server, which is no different than what you would do. You have a server and you install an OS on it. So instead of installing an OS like Windows 12, Windows 2012 or 2016, you install the ESX hypervisor, and then you directly connect to the hypervisor and install virtual machines on top of it. Now the beauty of it is, because this is all virtual, all these are virtual machines, anything which is in your computer, you manage it as a file, right? So these are like files for you now, and you can manage them very efficiently. You can move them around, you can, you know, add resources when you like and stuff. So let's discuss a little bit about type 2 hypervisor. So let me draw a decent server again here. So you have this CPU, you have your memory banks here, again network, say we have the hard disk. On top of this, if it is a hosted hypervisor, you have an OS installed. So for example, let's say I'm running a hosted hypervisor which will be on my Windows 10 machine. So I have the bare metal, which is my laptop, and on top of it I have a host, which is the operating system, which is Windows 10, and on top of that I'll be running a piece of software which will be the hypervisor. Now there are number of hypervisors available. So for example, you have Oracle VirtualBox, you have VMware Workstation, and then you have, we used to have something called there's another one which is Hyper-V. So there are a number of hypervisors available as hosted, but as you can see, when you run VMs on top of this, majority of the time you will see the operating system, the host operating system, is directly running on the bare metal. So it is going to take most of the resources, and then the hypervisor is going to come into the picture, and then it is going to share the resources between the host operating system and the virtual machines then, which is running here. And as you can see, the virtual machines and then the host hypervisor, then the OS, and then you have the bare metal. Over here is tightly coupled, so you just have a thin layer of ESX and it's run on top of the ESX host. So type 1, bear in mind, type 1 hypervisor is the bare metal hypervisor. ESX server is the VMware hypervisor, which we'll be learning. The version we'll be learning is 6.7. There are other, just to give you some idea, there are other bare metal hypervisor or the hypervisors out there in the market. Example, Zen server is one of them, and you have KVM, but then obviously it comes in under the category of hosted as well. But yeah, these are some of the examples. And over here, hosted hypervisors, as I said, Oracle, Virtual Box, or VMware Workstation. Okay, so we need to keep in mind that this is a important topic. If you have any questions, feel free to comment, and then I'll be happy to look into or address those questions. Be sure to subscribe to my channel and like my videos and share it with your friends. You can reach out to me at Ibrahim Qureshi on Twitter, and my blog is ibrahimqureshi.com. And I would love to hear from you. Leave a comment below and tell me if you like the topic I'm covering, if you want me to go a little bit slower, or you want me to go in detail on a specific topic which I discussed in this video. I would love to hear from you. So thank you very much. And my next video will be coming very soon. So be sure to subscribe, and I'll cover, as I discussed, the different type of clouds. And it's an interesting topic for someone who wants to learn virtualization. So don't miss out on that. Thank you. Bye.